All right, so today has been incredibly stressful. And scary, and I have cried a lot. But this morning I woke up, came downstairs, and my mom was like, Aurora fell off the balcony, so right up here. I think I've even vlogged her before, walking on the balcony, and it stresses me out so much. And I'll be like, Aurora, get down, Aurora, get down. Like, it just freaks me out, and I'll just be like, massive anxiety. And that's the reason, because she fell today from up here. My mom was like in the room, saw her, couldn't get to her in time. She fell, and there's nothing under it, so she just fell onto wooden floors, and she landed on her side, not on her feet, because she is the clumsiest little ungraceful lady. I'm so emotional already. And so it was really scary. She was just walking around really stiff-legged, and when she laid on her side, like, she couldn't get comfortable, and then when she tried to be on the couch with me and lay on her side, she would cry. And so it was really scary because, you know, we didn't have anyone to take her to the vet. So if we were going to take her to the emergency vet, today's Saturday, we've been self-isolating, so we would have to break self-isolation to go in and take her. Thankfully, our vet has a 24-hour weekend emergency hotline, so we called, but it's not immediate. So, you know, you call, you leave a message, you wait for them to call you back. Then she had to go talk to the vet, and then they were like, all right, we'll schedule you for 5 o'clock. So that was even after then, that was about 5 hours after it happened. Because at first we were just like, we don't know what's wrong. She seems to be walking, but she just couldn't get comfortable. She would jump up on things and her back legs seemed fine. But when she jumped down, her front legs would seem to like give out. But again, it didn't seem like they were broken or like anything was wrong there. It was more like her chest area, but she was breathing okay. It was just really concerning and scary. And then I was laying down on the floor because she was on the floor and she just came and laid on me. I was like on my side like this, being like, hi Aurora, how are you? She just came and laid on me in the weirdest places. I'll insert some pictures here, but she came over and was just doing the weirdest things, trying to be as close to me as possible, which obviously just made me like cry because she's very cuddly, but she's not usually like that. Like, it was very abnormal behavior. So we took her to the vet. Everything is fine, as far as we know. So no broken bones. The vet, like, you know, felt her, and she was like, her lungs feel fine, her lungs sound fine. It just seems like she's really sore. It hurt. So the vet gave her a pain med, and she has just been kind of conked out since then, which is really good. But I think that nap that she took on me, I mean, I was laying on the floor for like more than an hour, probably 2 hours. I'm so sore, but I was like, anything for my baby. So the vet gave her the pain med, and it really seems to help. She's just been sleeping it off now. So that was my Saturday. Very scary. I was like preparing myself for the end because she has a lot of other health issues. And so your brain just freaks out, right? I was like, did something internally happen? Did she, you know, have internal bruising or bleeding? But she seems okay. And so we're just gonna monitor her. But the vet was like, she's just sore and she's fine. So this is what she looks like right now. So this is her. She has just been laying here for a lot of the evening since we brought her back from the vet. So she is definitely doing better now. But yeah, it has just been like a really scary day. She scared me so much and I was just freaking out, and it was really stressful seeing her cry, obviously just from being in pain when she would do certain movements. So I think she's okay. Fingers crossed. Thank you, everyone. When I was posting on Instagram, people were so sweet and were messaging, being like, is she okay? What's going on? We're sending her positive thoughts. Thank you. thank you. It really means so much. And hopefully, fingers crossed, she is on the road to recovery, but I will continue to update everyone. If I ever see her on this balcony again, I will lose my mind. So anyway, thank you so much for all of your messages and your thoughts, and I will keep you updated on how she recovers. All right, a few more updates that I've been working on today in between doing a bunch of other stuff. My desk is looking so cute. So Aurora, I believe, is going to go over there right there.
But this is still a mess. Still packaging some stuff, getting ready for a meeting here. Over here, this side table, I actually took off the books that were on there. These I need to dust and deal with, but I put a lot of them here. So these are all the books that I am like currently reading. Well, my mom has the middle shelf and mine are on the top and the bottom, the books that I have started, and it's a lot. I bounce from book to book. That's just what I do. There's Aurora. So yes, it has been a lot today. Let me sit down and tell you about it. So I went to get blood taken because I needed two different blood tests. One is called Cyrex, and it's all these tests that are like, what are you allergic to, basically? Because my body reacts to literally everything. I guess I like rub myself and now it's red. So wanted to get that done, and my mom had called to see what we like maybe needed to pay to try figuring it out. The person on the phone would not tell her, and she was on hold for like 30 minutes. We go in and they're like, oh, you can't get this. It has to be done before 9 a.m. And we were like, nowhere does it say that in the Cyrex stuff. The Quest person when we called did not say that. It was like, are you kidding me? So we couldn't do that test, but I also needed to get my iron levels taken to see if I have improved and if I'm not anemic anymore. Fingers crossed. I have been eating so much iron-rich foods, so much meat, so much greenery, broccoli slaw, kale chips, an iron tonic that my mom has made. I have just been stocking up. So fingers crossed that that number has improved, because if not, I don't know where the iron is going. So that was just a lot. And then I had to call when I was home about a medication that apparently the prescription had run out and the doctor's office had not called me, and my prescription service had been calling the doctor's office and trying to contact them for a month now. And so I had to schedule a virtual appointment and get all of that figured out. And it was just a nightmare, get all these forms done. I mean, literally when I got home, it took 2 hours to do all of that because they needed a blood pressure. So all these cardiologist appointments I've had to do, when I got my echo, they did blood pressure. So then I had to call the place where I got my echo done and have them send it over to this other office. It was absolute mess, but yeah. So now I have an hour and a half before my next meeting, so I need to prepare for that. But I did organize like my desk area a little bit, and that's just my happy place, is organizing. And so I do it as a little palate cleanser when I'm so frustrated with like all the health stuff or whatever. So yes, I'm feeling pretty good, but let me show you what I was gonna work on. So I wanna take some of our sample like stickers and patches and put them in this display case that I found and see if that would be cool to like show people when I'm on meetings or whatever. It is very glassy, like I think it might be kind of hard for people to see with the reflection, so it might not work, but I did want to try just in case, because it would protect everything, they wouldn't get dust on them, stuff like that. So I'm gonna try putting that in there right now and let's see how it looks. All right, that was so difficult to get the little pins to line back up into their holes, but I think it looks pretty cute. Yay. So yeah, I think this will just be helpful for me to like point to stuff, as long as in my room there's not a window opposite me, so it should be easier to be like, here's our manatee. And if they really want to see like, here's our Ukraine design, I still have ones that I can hold up and get really close to them. These are our, you can't really see those thread because these are ornaments that are also stickers on the back. So I think this will just protect them a little bit better. And yeah, I'm really excited that I got them all in there. Yay, I did it. I also still have our wall art that I can hold up and show people as well, which I think is really cool, and be like, get in real close and be like, this is what it looks like close up. So I'm excited. This will be a good display piece to hold up to people now. Yeah, all right, I'm excited. Worth it. All right, I am gonna put these stickers on because I have yet to put them on anything, and I think I'm gonna put them in this corner. Let's do this. All right, I think I'm gonna put it Ukraine polar bear and then be positive. Okay, let's put
the Ukraine one on first. Oh, good. My dad did a little slash so I know where it is and I can peel it that way. Don't we love that? Beautiful. All right, let's see here. Okay, let's go on to the bear. And then finally, be positive. And we're done.